Hey everyone, I'm Valentin from DM Trading Bulgaria. In today's vlog, I'm going to make a trade dissection of one of my previous trades. The trade in question is the copper. I posted it 2 weeks ago. I'm going to start with the chart time frame daily, just to give you a quick reminder what was the main idea of this plan. So even though that I was thinking the most probable scenario is for the price to go on the long side, I made both way scenarios. And yeah, first of all, I know that there is a lot of stuff written here, but we are just going to use them in a minute, so bear with me. As you can see here, I posted the plan, and the main idea was whenever I see that the price is breaking the action zone from above or from the bottom side, to enter into a long position. And what happens, the price started to drop and actually break the action zone from below. So the plan that I've implemented was the one going short. Let me just change the graph so we can examine this more closely. So here, as you can see, after this consolidation right in the middle of the action zone, the price started to decline and break just below this area here, which was the end of the action zone. And this consolidation was my mark that I'm going to implement the short scenario. So basically I decided that after this support level here, which is around 2.76, I'm going to enter into a short position. If I zoom in just a little bit more, you can examine just what I did. So here the idea was as follows. After the drop, the price break this support level, but I decided to wait for the 1 hour bar to close, and just before the 1 hour end, a huge buying pressure appears and moves the price just below the support level. So I decided to wait for another hour. Here, as you can see, at first the price started to rise and then it started to drop again. So here in the end of the 30 minute candle, I've entered into a short position. After that, the price continues to drop and it make a series of small corrections. It tested again the support level here, as you can see, but then it continues to drop. This signal for me was enough to hold the position and to hope for a better profit. But on the next day, as you can see, the price started to rise rapidly. It breaks the previous support level, which was now a resistance, and enter again into the action zone. Here I decided that if the price reaches the levels around 2.81, I was going to make a decision. If the buying pressure is strong, I was going to close the position here, or maybe to reduce some of the exposure, or if I see that the buying pressure is not that strong and there is a chance for the price to continue dropping, I was going to hold the whole position. Luckily, this wasn't necessary. The price started to drop right after this movement again and continues to this level here. As you can see, the price was moving into this range for several days and forms the support area here, which I'm going to mark for you now as well, so you can see it more properly. It was somewhere around 2.739, 2.74, somewhere around this area. And I decided that if the price went through it, I'm going to be able to extract a very good profit from this position, because from here to below, there was nothing to stop it and it was probably going to reach the main target. However, as you can see here, several days later, the price started to rise rapidly. There was a huge buying pressure. There was just right after the Fed. I'm still not sure what causes this price movement, but as soon as the price reaches again the level here, I made the decision to close the 100% of the position in order to minimize my loss. After this, the price made this doji and it made a correction on the short side. So I was thinking that from here it will probably continue to drop, or it will continue going to my stop loss. So actually what happens with a relatively weak buying pressure, the price was slowly rising, and here this candle reaches almost my stop loss here. It didn't hit it, and after this the price dropped rapidly. That makes me very mad, because even though the plan was correct, it was almost impossible to make the correct decisions and the correct trade management. Nevertheless, the price continues to drop, and as you can see, after this small some sort of a consolidation here, it started to rise again. Let me just zoom in out for you, just to can examine it more properly. Here it breaks this support level that I've drawn for you earlier. I'm going to continue it for you now, just to can examine it more properly. So here the idea was that the price breaks it and just went and just stays for a little bit time below it. After this, I was thinking that this is a test of the support, but which is a resistance now. But actually the price started to rise again. So this gave me the idea that the movement in this security are very unpredictable. So probably I'm just going to observe it, not to take any actions, because it was most likely to lose money. And as a trader, I'm trying to take a reasonable risk with the highest probability of profit. Nevertheless, the price continues dropping. It breaks this support level, made a small correction, and now it's, as you can see, it's continued dropping. If I change the chart, you can examine that probably it will be able to reach the main target. So actually the plan was correct. It was just very hard to make the correct trade management, and probably here, as you can see, the only good thing is that we can conclude that our stop loss was very correctly placed. So because it didn't hit it, even though the buying pressure was very strong, and now the price is continuous falling on our way. Nevertheless, we are not in the trade, so there is nothing to sorry about. I made the decision, and I reduced my eventual losses, and probably at the time that was the correct decision. But we'll see what's going to happen, and if the price reaches the target area, and if someone is still holding the trade, just please contact me, because this will make me very happy, and hopefully you're realizing a very good profit from this very hard trade. And yeah, this was everything that I wanted to share with you about this trade dissection. If you like this video and you want to see more of our free trading plans and our vlogs, you can always subscribe to our YouTube channel. And our trading plans are also supported with live signals. They're making the trade, the following KFR trades very easy, and by them you can examine exactly what decision we are making about our trade management. So if you're interested, you can subscribe to our official Twitter account and our Telegram channel, because the signals are available there. Thank you very much for watching. I hope this video was helpful for you to understand what went wrong with this plan, and what was the main idea behind it. So probably next time we are going to be able to extract even better profit. I wish you a nice and pleasant day, and see you tomorrow on the recap. Bye bye.